I like gifts.
We covered that, I think.
Yeah. So the world's greatest news.
Paper television.
Podcast. The world, what?
That's the name of this podcast.
The world's greatest news.
The world's greatest newspaper television podcast.
The world's greatest newspaper television broadcast.
Podcast. This is a podcast.
The world's greatest. I don't even see that
on here. It's not on here.
The world's greatest newspaper.
Television. Podcast.
Podcast. You spelled my name wrong on here, man. That's why you can't use it. That's why you can't use my first name. Hey, the world's greatest newspaper television podcast.
That's it. You did it.
Now, what I'm supposed to be doing right now? Oh, I just forgot my train. Oh, so you guys, the world's greatest newspaper television podcast owes me gifts.
Oh, is that what you think?
Oh, yeah.
Why do I owe you gifts?
Because I did a podcast show.
I think this is going to be the intro bit. Let's roll the intro.
This is
WGN Television 9.
Channel 9.
Channel 9, Chicago.
Chicago.
Coming to you from atop the John Hancock Building.
Welcome to the world's greatest newspaper television podcast. I'm Brian Say.
And I'm Security Director Friday.
You're not Ross.
No, I'm Friday.
That's right. Ross is still on his honeymoon. Well, Friday, on this week's show, a text message sends me on a whimsical caper. I go on a sort of wild goose chase, a Garfield Goose and Friends goose chase, hunting down anchors to test their Channel 9 knowledge. It's all part of a new segment we're calling the Anchor Ambush.
That sounds exciting. And later, Brian interviews me. Which is more exciting.
That's right, and at the end of the show, we listen to some viewer voicemails. But first... Ross, you're back!
Hey, what's going on here?
You weren't here, so Friday's filling in for you.
Thanks, Friday. I'm back now, though, so you can go?
I think not. This is my podcast now, buddy. Let's go.
No, just give me the microphone. Give me the microphone.
Let it go. Ross, let it go, man.
Oh, Friday. Okay, Uncle, can we just do riffing with Ross, please?
I guess.
Time now for riffing with Ross.
Yeah. Man, Friday, she's got a strong grip.
Yeah, she's really feisty. So you're back. Tell me about the honeymoon, buddy.
Well, Brian, that's private, but I can tell you where I went. The mystical lands of Ireland and Portugal.
Oh, that sounds mystical. What was your favorite part?
Well, we really loved everything about Portugal, but the cliffs of Moher in Ireland were breathtaking. Brian, close your eyes and imagine this for a second. You're hundreds of feet up over the Atlantic Ocean. Waves crashing against the rocks. A cool wind blows. The birds call out. A majestic rainbow appears in the sky. Ethereal music plays over soaring views. A pint of Guinness touches your lips. But anyways, that was about it. Nothing special.
Time now for the Anchor Ambush. This week, I'm testing the WGN Morning News B team. These are the younger anchors who hold down the fort from 4 to 6 a.m. on the WGN Morning News. They're millennials in their 20s and 30s. Dan Ponce is out this week, so I had his good friend Courtney Hall fill in for him. The idea for this segment started with a text message from a viewer. Friday, do you mind reading that?
From 847, Morgan, do you believe in ghosts? Is WGN Hunted by Fraser Thomas?
Thanks, Friday. So this text is for meteorologist Morgan Kolkmeyer, the newest addition to the WGN Weather Office. Since she's a millennial, I thought, does Morgan even know who Fraser Thomas is? If our listeners don't know, Fraser Thomas is the man behind Garfield, Goose, and Friends, which aired here on WGN in the 50s and 60s.
And I want to tell you, March has been pretty good to us so far, hasn't it? Hasn't been too bad. Not too bad. But you know, they say when it comes in like a lamb, it may go out like a lion. So we may have a few blizzards before this is over. All you can do is hope for the best. Expect the worst, and take what you get. My grandmother used to say that, and my grandmother was right. Exact. Grandmothers know best, don't they? You bet your life they do, Mama.
Fraser was also the ringmaster for Bozo in the 70s, and he hosted Family Classics on Friday nights on WGN. For this anchor ambush, I gathered some photos of a few legendary WGN personalities and tested the B-Team's Channel 9 knowledge.
Good morning, Morgan. So I got this text message. It says, Morgan, do you believe in ghosts? Is WGN haunted by Fraser Thomas? So that got me thinking. Do you know who Fraser Thomas is? Be honest.
I think I've heard the name.
You've heard the name, but you don't know who it is?
No.
All right, well, I appreciate your honesty. I've got some headshots here of five legendary WGN personalities. I want you to try to see if you can pick him out of this lineup.
Oh, man. I'm going to say this guy.
That is correct. That's Fraser Thomas.
See, I kind of do.
So I can't believe you got it. So does he look familiar to you?
No, I just guessed.
That's a good guess. There should be somebody else there that you'd recognize.
Really?
The woman doesn't look familiar to you at all?
No.
That's your mom.
Is that Linda? Oh, yes, Mom. Looking good.
And for the record, that's not actually your mom.
No, it's not my mom, but we have a similar last name.
You sure do. All right. Thanks for being a good sport.
Thanks for having me.
Hello, Jiggets.
Hello, Brian.
How are you?
I'm doing wonderful. How are you?
I'm great.
This looks like a breathalyzer.
It is. Are you drunk, Jiggets?
No, just drunk on life.
Just pregnant.
Yeah, just pregnant, exactly.
So we got a text message, and it's turned into a bit of a game. It's more of a test.
Okay.
Are you ready to do this?
Yes, let's do it.
All right, so Fraser Thomas, do you know who that is?
No.
Fraser Thomas was on WGN many years ago. He did Garfield, Goose, and Friends.
Oh, okay, I'm sorry, yes.
Is this ringing a bell?
Yes, I was thinking of Fraser, sorry.
You were thinking of Fraser Crane?
Yes.
No, not that Fraser.
Where my brain is right now.
All right, do you think you could pick Fraser Thomas out of a lineup?
I'm not sure. I never watched Garfield Goose as a kid.
All right, well, let's see if you can pick him out. Here we go. This is the test. Right. Here are a bunch of WGN personalities. Can you identify which one is Fraser Thomas?
Well, I know that one is Linda Kohlmeyer.
Very good.
I'm going to guess this one.
That's the one.
Okay. Yes.
Marcus Leshock, nice to have you here.
Great to be here.
So do you know who Fraser Thomas is?
Yeah, Fraser Thomas from the old shows here at WGN.
That's exactly...
Before my time, but I'm familiar with Fraser Thomas, yes.
Of course, Garfield, Goose, and Friends.
Garfield, Goose, correct.
Do you think you could pick him out of a lineup?
Yeah, hope so. Fraser Thomas would be these two...
Go with your gut.
Is this it?
That's the one.
Right, okay, gotcha. Gosh, these two guys look pretty similar. This looks like... Who's this?
That's Jack Brickhouse.
Jack Brick... Wow.
Well, once again, welcome to the 10th inning program back here at Candlestick Park, ladies and gentlemen. I'm Jack Brickhouse. The Cubs just won a thriller.
Do you recognize any of those other people?
Well, Linda Kohlmeyer, obviously.
Morgan didn't even recognize her mom.
No, yeah, that is her mother. I don't know how good their relationship is, so she might have just completely cut her off by now. Who's this?
That's Ray Rayner.
That's Ray Rayner?
People stop and stare. They don't bother me. For there's nowhere else on earth that I would rather be. And that I'm alone, I don't care if I'm as long on the street where you live.
I lost my place. I lost my place.
And who is this?
That's Lou Rawls.
Lou Rawls. I was going to say, is that Lou Rawls? Wow.
That's a loose affiliation with WGN.
Of the morning. Yeah.
All right, I'm here with Courtney Hall. She's applying some makeup for her live hit in a few moments. Hello, Courtney.
Hello. You got a touch up, you know.
Of course. I don't know anything about that, but. So we got a text. It asked Morgan about Fraser Thomas. Do you know who Fraser Thomas is? That's fine. Do you think you could pick him out of a lineup?
Sure. Maybe. No. I won't.
Let's try.
Well, that's Lou Rawls.
Very good. You're the first one who got him right away.
Yeah. This one.
Everyone guesses him. Yes, that's Fraser Thomas.
He looks like a Fraser Thomas.
Does he?
He does.
So, Sarah Gendra, hello, how are you?
I'm good, Brian, how are you?
I'm phenomenal. So we got a text message. It was asking Morgan about Fraser Thomas. Do you know who Fraser Thomas is?
No.
No idea?
No.
Garfield Goose and Friends?
That sounds familiar.
Sounds familiar. All right, here are several WGN personalities. Okay. Can you pick out Fraser Thomas?
That guy.
No.
No. No.
You're the first one to get it wrong, too. Can I tell you that?
What?
Everyone else is not necessarily known, but they've all guessed the right one.
What? This guy.
No, that's Ray Rayner.
Oh, shit.
The first one was Jack Brickhouse, by the way.
Oh, jeez.
There you go. Third time's a charm.
Oh, jeez.
That's Fraser Thomas. Does anybody else here look familiar?
No.
Really? You don't recognize the woman?
I don't know. Who is this?
It's Morgan's mother.
Stop it. Oh, my God.
Not legitimate. It's Linda Kolkmeier.
No, right. Cole, not Kolkmeier. Oh, that's fantastic. Okay. Now, was this whole goal of this to make us look stupid?
A little bit of that. A little bit of trying to educate.
No, this is good.
How do you feel that you were the first person to get it wrong?
Just edit me out of this. I'm trying to help your podcast. You needed one idiot in there. So there you go. I'm your idiot.
Well, thanks, Sarah, You're for being welcome. The idiot.
You're welcome.
Well, that's it for Anchor Ambush. Sarah had to go hop into Skycam 9. See you later, Sarah. Time now for conversations with the world's greatest. This week, WGN's head of security, Friday. She's like Prince. She only uses one name. She's the first person we see when we all walk in, and she's in the market for a min pin. Friday, did you find a furry friend yet?
Not yet, Brian. And thank you so much for having me on.
Of course. Thank you for being here. I'm so excited that you're here.
I am too.
Tell me about your min pin hunt. What are you looking for?
I am looking for a chocolate tan female miniature pincher puppy.
Why that specific dog?
Well, I like big dogs. I'm a Rottweiler type of person or a big Doberman Pinscher type of person. But due to these owners of these properties, they won't allow me to have a dog that's more than 25 pounds.
So you need a min pin.
I need a min pin until I get a house.
What about min pins?
It is a small Doberman Pinscher. It still has the mentality of a full-size Doberman Pinscher. It's just little.
So you want some fight in your dog?
I want some aggressiveness. I want some gnaw at your heels or some piss on your leg if you come in. I'm just saying small, big attitudes can come in small packages like myself.
Yeah, no, that fits you quite well.
Thank you, Brian.
So tell me, how long have you been the head of security here at WGN?
It's between 5 and 8 years. I cannot keep track of when I actually came over here.
Time flies when you're having fun.
Oh, of course. Every day is a ball.
Are you being serious right now?
I am.
I can't tell if you are or you aren't.
Right. See, they don't have the facial. You guys can't see.
Right.
But of course I'm being serious.
Well, I think that's why you're the head of security, because there's a little ambiguity there. Like, is she being serious or not? I can't tell.
Right.
Very good poker face.
That's wonderful. I practiced this for a very long time. I also have a FAS, you guys.
What does that mean?
Fake it. Smile. It's like you can turn it on and then turn it off.
FAS.
Yes, FAS.
When I put on a smile, do you think I'm giving you an FAS?
You know, you never smile, Brian.
That's not even true. I smile all the time.
Not at me.
Well, that's because you and I see each other in the hallway, and I feel like we have a very long hallway here at WGN, and when I'm walking down that hallway, I'm always kind of thinking about, what do I have to do? So I'm in my head when I'm walking down that hallway, and that's when I see you, and then you think I'm like mean mugging you.
I've never seen a smile from you. I've heard a chuckle, a giggle, a laugh, but not a smile.
That's not even, I'm smiling right now. That's not even true.
I think that's a FAS.
Could be. Maybe it is. Are you having fun yet?
Of course not.
I appreciate your honesty.
My nose is really itching, and I know there's something up there, and I really want to get it out, but I wouldn't do that in front of you, right? You know?
Well, I appreciate that.
Okay.
If you have to get in there, don't let me.
Oh, I wouldn't hesitate, but I would turn. Yeah, I would turn around.
I mean, if we need to break now, you can pick your nose.
No, I don't want to take a break to pick my nose. But the more you talk about it, the more it's itching. I told you, I feel like I'm a little nasally. I'm trying to do my Eartha Kitt.
What does that mean?
Rawr.
Are you trying to channel someone that I have not heard of?
No, don't you know Eartha Kitt?
No.
The one who played the first Catwoman?
No.
Oh, come on.
I'm a young man.
Oh, Brian, look her up. Google it.
Eartha Kitt?
Eartha Kitt.
Was she was on the Batman, the TV series with Adam West?
Yes.
Yeah, okay.
She was the first Catwoman. She purrs. That's what Eartha does. She purrs.
This is a stupid question, but what's your favorite part of working at WGN?
I feel like I'm in here for an interview for a promotion, man. You know?
That's fair. It's a terrible question.
What's my favorite part of working at WGN? My favorite part, I guess it would be the interaction with the people that work here on a daily basis. That would be my favorite part.
You have fun here.
I have a lot of fun. And they say when you find your purpose, it's not a job. So I found my purpose.
You really feel that way?
Found my purpose. I have social anxiety. So for me to get up every day and be happy about coming out and, you know, greeting everybody and being nice to everybody all day, every day, because I'm not a very nice person, you know. But I do, you know, I get through the day.
And so you like to be here. You like the people here.
I love the people that work here and the people that visit here. And this is a great place for me to be.
How's that booger feeling?
I think it went away.
Did it?
You didn't see me get it.
Did you get it? Was I looking away? Oh, my goodness. You're a bit of a goofball.
Yeah, I can be.
Yeah. And I think people here have recognized that.
Oh, yeah.
And Pat Tomasulo, the man of the people, he's had you on a couple of times. Talk to me about those experiences.
Oh, boy. Sometimes you agree to do things and you sit back and you think about them and you be like, what did I do that for? Those were those occasions.
You did a bit recently. Well, it was a couple months ago with Pat where you and Mike, another security guard here, sat down with Pat and you watched The Walking Dead. Tell me.
At my house.
Yeah, it was at your house, wasn't it?
Yes.
It was very nice of you to host them.
Wasn't it? For some boom chicka pop.
What is that? What is that?
Popcorn. That's popcorn.
Oh, you're right. That's right. You made some popcorn.
No, they brought Boom Chicka Pop. That was my payment for being on Man of the People, you guys.
Oh, they brought the popcorn?
Because I requested it, yes.
Is that all you requested? You didn't have another list of demands?
I had a whole list of demands. I didn't get anything else.
What else was on the list?
Just all kind of stuff. Like, can we get something to eat?
Sure.
And, you know, can you bring me some beer?
Yeah.
You know.
Yeah. And they just brought popcorn.
They just brought Boom Chicka Pop.
So, but how was that? That was a fun time for you.
It was fun. You know, we actually sat there, you know, that's TV. So, you know, we sat there for an hour and, you know, but the cut was very good. I really was proud of myself. I send that to, you know, when I have prospects, when I'm dating right now, I mean, we're not going to talk about that, but I send that video to them so that they can see, you know, how I act sometimes.
And so you've done other bits with Pat, and you're a recurring character at this point.
Not quite. We got to sit down and negotiate some stuff.
What do you want?
I want a miniature pincher, Pat. Chocolate.
Well,
everybody at the station can pitch in and get me this.
That's actually not a bad idea. That should be a bit.
And I should let Paul Rennie know, who is the GM of the station, you guys.
He's sitting right across the hall.
Paul, you're going to hear this. I want a miniature pincher for Christmas. That's all Friday wants. Make every department pitch in because everybody loves me.
How much is a female puppy minpin?
Between $8 and $1,500.
That's a hefty chunk of change.
Oh, everybody pitch in $20. I mean, you we'll get it.
If everybody pitches in $2, we'd probably get
exactly.
there.
Exactly.
Hundreds
everybody,
of people work here.
Yes, everybody. And I know everybody.
You know everybody's name here.
I do.
Don't lie to me.
I know everybody. People come to me and ask me people's names.
You know.
It took me 4 months to learn everybody's name in here. First shift, third shift. All and I only work one shift, and I know people want third shift.
Every single person's name at
WGN. I know every single person's name, even the interns as they come and go. And then I know some of their family members also, wives, kids.
Yeah, why don't we talk about dogs. That? My family came in recently.
They sure did, and I told your mom to whoop your butt.
That's exactly what happened.
Uh-huh.
And you actually, I think you took off your belt and gave handed it.
I handed it to her.
Yeah.
Yes,
she didn't beat me because my mother loves me.
Oh, she should have whooped you. I told her you were being naughty.
That's not even true.
Oh, no, it's not. Okay.
All right. What else do I have here? We're almost done.
Isn't that great?
Are you not having a nice time?
I am. I'm enjoying myself a little bit.
Just a little, though.
Yeah, I got shit to do, man.
Like, what do you got to do?
I got stuff. I got security stuff. I can't discuss that.
Top secret.
Top secret squirrel. All
right, let's do a lightning round here.
Okay.
Apple or Android?
Android.
All right, favorite candy?
Ferrero Rocher.
Those chocolates?
Yes.
Brand of cigarettes?
Newport Lights.
Favorite meal?
Favorite meal. Collard greens with ham hocks, candy sweets, and fried pork chops, cornbread.
And you make that for yourself often, or do you?
I do at least once a month.
Mm, that sounds good.
Yeah.
You've shared a lot today, and I really appreciate it.
I have, and I really don't like people all in my business like this.
Well, I'm happy you opened your doors to us. All right, well.
So what did you learn from this segment, Brian, about me? What did you learn?
What I learned is that you can sometimes have a rough exterior, as many of us can,
mm-hmm.
but you're a bit of a teddy bear in there.
See there, you guys. Well, I can be nice. You know, I sat here for a whole however long this been, and I did not curse once.
You cursed several times.
No,
fake it. Smile is the word. This is a curse word.
Oh, that's not a curse word. This is a donkey.
Well, Friday, thank you so much for sitting down with me. I really appreciate it.
Thank you, Brian. I love to be appreciated. I feel so blessed to have been considered for this. I mean, seriously, like, this is podcast number 3.
Mm-hmm.
And I am here, you guys.
I can't tell if you're being genuine or not.
I am.
Are you?
In a way. It has not been a waste of time.
Well, that's very good to hear. I agree.
Peace, hair grease. I'm out, Brian. I gotta go.
Your name after the tone, and Google Voice will try to reach.
WGN voicemail.
Why is Conrad on at 9:37 p.m. on a Saturday night? You're messing with my head. Jeez.
Hey, guys. I watch a show every day with my woman. You guys are hilarious and your best news team in the town because you guys are just off the cuff and awesome.
Hi, this is First Sergeant David Moore from the 82nd Airborne Division in Fort Bragg, from the guys from 1st by the 504th Alpha Company, 1st Brigade, 1st Battalion. Some of us are in town today, so we want to say that we love you guys to death. And it's from the 82nd Airborne Division, Fort Bragg. We love you guys. Take care now. Out.
You know, I'm not a woman expecting a baby, but your show gives me morning sickness.
Hi, Vanessa Brown. I'm trying to find out the email address where I can upload my photos to for Tom's Killing. I have an amazing photo that I'd like to share. All right. Thank you. Have a blessed day.
I am just wondering who dressed Paul Lisnick this morning. What is with that bow tie? It is just wrong, wrong, wrong.
That's it for episode 3. Hey, First Sergeant David Moore from the 82nd Airborne, we love you too, man. Thank you for your service. And Vanessa, if you head on over to chicagoweathercenter.com/photos, you can upload your pics for Tom right there.
And for the record, I love Paul Lisnick's bow ties. Hey Ross, you a big bow tie guy?
No man, I don't understand them. You have to be a magician to like put them on or tie them. I'm more of a double Windsor guy.
Yeah, you've always been a big double Windsor guy.
You know me.
I do. Big thanks to the Morning Show B-Team, Courtney Hall, and the head of security here at WGN, Friday. Hey Friday, do you mind if Ross stays on as my co-host?
Well, since you asked nicely, Brian, I guess. See you guys. Thanks for listening to me.
Thank you, Friday. You've been listening to the world's greatest newspaper television podcast.
AKA WGNTVP for short.
Yeah, for short. Until next time, tune in to Channel 9.
In March of last year, I interviewed Frazier. He shared these feelings about the business.
Comedy is a very serious form of drama. And when you try to get ready to do a piece of comedy, a comedy bit, sometimes the preparation for it is a very serious thing. It has to be done just exactly right. And what looks so thrown together and so easy to do sometimes takes a lot of preparation.